Okay, before the lecture starts, I'd like to introduce you again. Professor Lin Chen is very skillful and very experienced doctor in from Zhuang's medicine. Zhuang medicine is actually from the local medicine. You cannot find it on the text, on a textbook. It's a very unique experience for you. Professor Lin Chen worked in Germany for 3 weeks for the lectures, also for the German students. This kind of medicine system is combined with the traditional Chinese medicine, this kind of branch. Okay, let's begin some lectures. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
这个药线点灸是咱们中医的一个灸法。
The medicated stress most functions are one of the most functions from the junk medicine.
它主要是用这个植物叫楚麻啊。We
can see on the map that there's a very special plant from a junk from our region, which is the
楚麻，就是麻，就是麻。
is in English is remet. It's made of the remet root.
加上一些壮族的一些药物啊，炮制啊。
If we prepare with the many kinds of the drunk medicine source.
有就用这个线啊，浸泡了一个月到两个月。
After so that's with the alcohol, after maybe 1 to 2 months, then we can use this rat.
And
first of all, I'd like to talk about the definitions. About the PPT, I will print it out maybe later. Mr. Yang will bring me the PPT. It's totally 10 papers. It's too much. I cannot make it before the lectures begin. So later you will get the paper. Definition.
就是用壮医的理论啊，来指导这个药线，来治疗啊，它和中医的针灸理论还是有一些差别的。So
it was guided by the traditional Zhuang medicines. It's a little bit different from the traditional Chinese medicine.
它是用它点着火以后啊，用一个烛火啊，等会我们再示范给大家啊，要直接的灼灸在人体的穴位或者是。
And later, we will demonstrate this kind of therapies with the threat.
可以治病，也可以防病。
With the threat, we can treat the diseases and to prevent the diseases.
药线点灸是咱们中医治疗。 疾病和防疫防疾病的一个重要手段和方法.
So this kind of therapy is one of the most important ways to treat the diseases in junk medicine.
它有点类似中医的灸法.
It is kind, it's kind of like most functions from the traditional medicine.
但是它比它中医的灸法治疗的病种还要多啊，效果还要好。
I would like to say the drugs most functions. It's a little bit more effective, more comprehensive than the traditional one.
这个是它灸法的一些情况，我们往下讲。我们这个药线点灸，它在治疗，在灸的时候啊，它可以不用考虑它的穴位啊，不一定要像中医一样去考虑它的穴位。
So when we apply this kind of therapies, we don't actually we don't think too much about acupoints.
我们说壮医要先研究在临床应研究中啊有十大主要功效。
There are total of ten functions from this kind of therapy, generally.
我们一一的介绍。第一个就是有消炎退热的作用。
And inflammations and defenses.
你像这个痔疮啊、口腔溃疡啊等等这些都可以用来治疗。
The hemorrhoid skin ulcer, ulcer of the mouth, sore throat and throat changes.
有祛风止痒的作用。第二个是它的主要功效。
The second function is to just bring the wind and to removing, to remove the itching.
对一些皮肤瘙痒的病症，效果非常好。
That treats the different kinds of the skin's problems.
第三个是通络止痛。
And to, as it says, open the meridian to stop the pain.
对一些痛症啊，你像头痛啊，还有女性的痛经啊，这些疾病效果非常好。
For all kinds of pain, such as the headache and abdominal pain and also the tooth pains, especially for the pains during the menstruations for women.
第四个有散结消肿的作用啊。像我们在临床中经常用于治疗乳腺增生啊，有一定的疗效。
Okay, we can reduce the swellings and restore the mass, especially memory perhaps to have a breath.
特别是有时候把外伤引起的肿痛啊，直接就灼灸在这个。肿痛的地方效果非常好。
If you make a therapist on the local area, we just got a hurt or injuries from the accidents, it works very, very good.
第五个就是消食开胃。
Irritation prevention and can stimulate the appetite.
对厌食症呢，可以提高他的食欲。
Improves the appetite and stimulate the appetite for kids.
一个就是健脾止泻，就是中医也是这么说。
We can cure the diarrhea due to the deficiencies of the spleen.
我们曾经在火车上帮一个泻得很厉害的病人，就直接灼灸，马上就可以止泻了，效果还是挺好的。
Here's tell us one story is on.There's one story that's the, and he has killed a patient on his chain. His chain? Real. In his chain. Chain. It's in a chain. There's a patient from the diarrhea. They used the therapy to solve these problems. And it works very effectively.
对急性胃肠炎效果是比较好的。
It's for the AGEs, especially for the acute cases, it works.
有温经通痹的作用。
The therapist and we can use it to warm the meridians and to open, to have a tone B as regulate the B system.
一些痹症，像我们西医说的风湿性关节炎，效果也还好。
Well, the rheumatoid arthritis have very good effect.
活血止血的功效，一般来说，点灸这个可以有活血作用，也可以止血。我们在临床中主要是对一些出血的病人。
出血
的一些病人，我们可以直接点灸这个出血的地方。
Okay, for the patients from the breathing, for the breathing cases, we can just use the different to make treatment for them.
但是我们用的药线的时候可能要稍长一点啊。
嗯哼。But for these cases, we have to use a longer thread for the patients.
宁心安神的作用。
That relieves the uneasiness of mind.
对一些药性点灸，对一些失眠呐、啊，也是不能睡呀、啊，还就是神经官能症的问题，效果都比较好的。
Just as we have things on the PPT, insomnia, the nervous, the therapist, nurses, also some symptoms due to the menopause.
这个功效是强壮补益的功效，对一些很虚的啊，你像我们中医说的一些可以补肾的啊。
Okay. You have to also have a function of the reinforcement, like such as the sun, the spleen, name, kidney reinforcement.
这是我们通常讲的十大功效啊，但是不是只有十大功效呢
？Of course, we have more than 10 functions.
实际上不是这样。
Of course not. Its function is more than that.
因为我们身上的300多个穴位还有不同的功效，所以在使用的时候，你配伍起来效果就更多了。
So as we know, as we have known that according to the traditional medicines, we have more than 300 acupoints on the body. If this kind of therapy is combined with the acupoints.Then we have more functions, we have more effectives.
你像我们讲的点灸止血的穴位可以治疗血泻，点灸通便的穴位就可以治疗便秘，还有点灸固涩小便的穴位还可以治疗遗尿，你的穴位都在这上边。
OK. According to the four features on the PPT, we have functions of treatment, types of treatments for the diarrhea, constipation, urinary obstructions, urinary. 是哪一个是指哪一个？
这个是上长强穴。
It's the upper 长强 point.
上长强，它跟长强还是差0.5寸。
It is half trend above the Chang Chang points.
We call it half Chang Chang points. This is for the diarrhea.
The same picture is for the diarrhea.
This is the upper Chang Chang points. This is the inner Nating points.
Nating
叫里内庭，它是内庭的另外一侧，在脚底下。
The inner Nating is on the other side.
这个就治疗便秘的。
We use this for the treatment.
但这两个正好，一个是泻的要止的，一个是拉不出来要泻的。
就是 box for the first pictures compared to the second pictures, we do have the two functions. One is for diarrhea, to stop, and the second one is for the constipation, just to make it out.
这个里内庭穴
which one is which?
不想怀孕了拿来堕胎的，但是我们现在都不敢用，也不敢研究这个的，因为。
Actually, the second features is for the obstetricians, but the the Zhuang's doctors, one experienced Zhuang's doctor has told him that we used to use the inner mating point to give out the baby abduction.
但是我们现在一直都不敢研究，因为它违反了我们国家的一些政策，所以都不去研究。但确实，他以前的人堕胎就是用这个穴位，用这个药线的啊。
And so far, we dare not to make any studies to on this egg points because it's illegal.
这个啊，就这个啊，就是内廷，内廷不是在。
So the natings on the upside, it's the on the downside.
It's foot, it's the 足底下。然后这个就是下关节，下关节就在关节穴下0.5寸。
下关节，这关节下零点五寸，
这个穴是一个强壮穴。
Lower guanyin point. Lower guanyin point is half turns below the guanyin. This kind of points as a function like a reinforcement.
这个壮阴是拿来做强壮线。
We use this point to make someone strong.
这个等会儿我们还可以跟大家介绍一下这几个穴位吧。
Later we'll discuss about it.
它有六个特点。
We have six, six features, characteristics for this.
它有这个适应症比较广，它可以治疗100多种疾病。
Comprehensive.
有简便连便捷的特点。
It's very simple, convenient, cheap, and effective.
没有什么毒副作用。
It was, of course, no side effect.
没什么。
它会有那个疤痕吗？
没有。
没有疤痕。
如果我有，我们每天都在做治疗，那就很麻烦了。没有疤痕，但是它点灸以后。
Without the scar.
它会有一点点痒，就过后，但是任何的疤痕都不会有。
But we have to pay attention to the.A little bit of blister. Because after treatment, we'll feel a little bit itching on the area. You have made a treatment as well.
No, we're saying quite a lot of scarring.
You're seeing a lot of scars?
Some old people had some very bad.
Maybe this from the fire?
No, we asked, and they said it's from the
tree. So,在一些那种老年人的话，他见过一些那个中医药，老年的那些这种疤痕。
哦，那可能不是药性研究，他是不是用那个灯火灸法，还有药别的疗法？
灯火灸。
不是，他还有一种是拿火来点的，有
火来点
啊，就是拿线点着火来点的，是不是这样的？
The doctor asks you if the patient accepts burning threats therapy. Just test the threats. Why does it burn? It still burns. It's like this.
Yeah.
那他们那全是手法掌握不好，一般我们这个点灸是没有什么。
会不会是那个老年人他那个是顽疾？
那不会，
比较大一点。
不会，那就是手法学习手法的问题了。
OK。
如果是这样，就手法掌握的。
So why some old patients got some scars from the treatment? The doctor has told us that maybe some doctors cannot handle some many operations. It needs some skill.
一个是手法，一个是火候的掌握。等一下我们会说这两个问题。
Later we'll talk about the many operations, how to make it perfect.
你也可以讲个故事给他听。我有一年去检查实习啊，到一个医院，有一个学生在做药线点灸。 结果给我看动作非常不规范，我就问他，你的老师是谁？他说我那个老师是姓林的，就说我了。我说叫林什么？他说叫林晨的。他根本就不认识我啊，所以结果我看我说你这个手法不对，结果他怎么不对？我说你要是林晨的学生，你知道林晨是谁吗？他林晨是我的老师，我怎么不知道？我说我就是林晨。
Here is also a very funny story. A long time ago, he went to some villages to check the training, to check a clinical training for the clinical doctors. Because we are TCM school, we educate many students, but here since one student just made treatments with the Zhuang's threat. The doctor says, you have made it totally wrong. You are in a wrong way. The doctor said, no. It is impossible. My master is Professor Ling Chen. And Professor Ling says, do you know who is Ling Chen? I am Ling Chen.
所以就很多就是说在手法上用的时候他不对，他也跟引起啊，可能听说或者是见人家做过，他就没有掌握好手法，所以用起来可能就有刚才说的那种疤痕，可能会就这火候太大了，手法太重了，反正就有这情况。
Maybe the scar because of the bad medications, less of strength.
一个最大的特点就是它可以跟其他的医学相互渗透，共同协助起作用，它这个是最好的。
So, when we apply this kind of therapies, we can also combine with the other medicines.
它不会说它用了以后减低别的其他的手段的疗效，而且它相反，它起到一个促进的作用。
When we combine the status medicines, the only functions we can see in the clinic is that the therapies increase the effectiveness.
这是我们这二十多年来用这个方法的时候，我们感觉到为什么现在就是它有点痛点的时候，而且有一点点火，让人有点畏惧啊。但实际上我们用起来的时候发现它很好用，所以我们就不能舍弃它，就这样。
And after 20 years of study, we have seen many, many kinds of cases. However, this kind of therapy is things that are very scared. There's a usual burning threat to tap on the body. Somebody will find it very dangerous. But it works very well. That's why we cannot give it up.Even today,
当你一种疾病，你用很多的方法都治疗不好的时候，你就可以考虑用这个药线研究来试一试。
Okay, before the treatments from the Zhuang's medicines, you may have tried many kinds of treatments, even from the Chinese way or from the Western medicines. And after that, then you can choose our medicines.
是因为很多疾病我们是在束手无策的时候，我们用这个来试，结果一试它就有效果，而且会治好很多的奇难杂症。
In some cases, the best of medicine do not have the solutions, but we have.
你像那个带状疱疹的后遗神经痛，就那个 PHN 那个。
The PHN. It means the pain symptoms after the herpes zoster.
Herpes zoster. 它的用事规律，我们大家要记住这个规律。
So we're going to remember just the coin selection rule.
壮要先点灸，它是讲规律，它基本上是不怎么管穴位的。
So in this kind of medicine, we care about the rule, and we don't care about the we don't care the acupoints, exactly.
我们壮义的针和灸基本上也是这个以痛为书吧。我在德国讲学，我也给他们介绍了这个壮义的针的理论啊，就是痛，就是我们中医说的啊，是穴比较使用的比较多。
嗯哼。So, the professor Linz has told also the German students that during the treatment, we selected mainly the acupoints compared to the meridians or some kinds of acupoints.
Okay.
Local and Ashi.
是我们中医和壮医在针灸方面的区别，我看也就是穴位和这个规律方面的一个认识问题。
So in this medicine, we talked about the rule is most important.
要先点灸的规律就是寒手热背肿在眉，肿块的就在眉花穴，就局部的一块一块的肿在眉，就像眉花一样。
对，你一直讲完，然后我就转一下。
啊。然后尾肌痛圆马洛央，唯有养肌抓掌指，那么所有的施灸就按这个方法，就不离乡，就是这个是规律。嗯，养的地方就抓最大，掌指就是我们中国人说的最大的额子，就是最大的那个。
So we do have the rules about the service because it's broken.It was wrote in the form like Han Shou Re Bei, that's all in Chinese. We have to translate this in English. So let's say the cold, and if we decrease the cold symptom, we use the hand, we use the points on hand. If we want to choose the hot symptom, we use the back. It means the back and the spine.And Wei syndrome, which is muscular atrophy, is if we want to choose the muscle with the Wei syndrome or the dumbness, we just choose the middles of the muscle. Like, for example, there's one single example.If we have the raising just on this muscle, we select the middle area. That's our point. If we do, we want to do with the skin's problems, it's for the skin, we select the Zhuang, means the biggest brushes. Zhuang in Chinese,we call it the biggest brothers in the Chinese family. Big brother.
它这个规律就是
Sorry, with numbness, is the numbness conditions, is that the same as the wasting? Or?
Yes, the way and the numbness.
So it's the same thing.
It's the same, okay.
这个寒手就是发冷的怕冷的有这个症状的，我们就在手上取穴位为主。
If you have the symptoms like a cold symptom, we select the hands as the point.
以前手上的穴位最常用的，我们就是啊，曲池、手三里这些，我们都在和骨啊，这些都是最常用的穴位。
So the 曲池 and 手三里，also the normal points with letters for the cold symptom.
热背啊，发热的， 人体体温升高的这类有就是西医说的有感染的疾病，我们都是背后取穴位啊。
If your body temperature is increased due to the inflammation,、
mm-hmm.
due to the inflammation, reduce the points on the back.、
嗯、你像最代表性的就是大叔啊，大椎这些啊。
大叔，大椎。大叔。
对，大叔大椎这些效果都比较好。
大叔大椎的 C7 我去清个下水会买那个热水，我杀了一只热水的东西。
其他还解释
在家里吃的下水过来不用那个总代没有还总代没有那个数吧。
总在酶就是我们说的一些肿块性的疾病，你像刚我们说啊，就打球扭伤的肿痛的这些，就在它肿的周边啊，一大肿块就整一块了，取一组穴位是一组啊，就点很多状的，很多点，就像这种局部酶化穴，等会我们还要解释，还要讲一个穴位。
For the treatment, if you like to make a treatment for this kind of patients, or from the injury, the patients had a swelling, then we will around the swelling, actually we want to select one set of points. It looks like the blooming flower. It's like a flower. It may have the five leaves. It looks like so. It's swelling is here. It's like here. It's actually around. Which is around it. Around the area.Five Zhuang. We said five Zhuang is fine, how to say, five tapping. Five points. Five points per tapping.
很聪明的吗？谢谢。我们讲讲这两个药性点灸和这个中医的穴位有什么不同啊？我们有三个不同的啊。
Okay, we're going to talk about the difference between the Zhuang medicine and the Chinese medicine.
一个我们中医药性点灸直接就使用中医的一个这300多个穴位。
Okay, our Zhuang medicines use also the acupoints from the traditional medicine.
也是用中医的这个穴位主治的病症，也就是说它。治什么病，我们也可以用来它治什么病。
This okay, those acupoints can cure different kinds of diseases. We do select it also for the treatment.
第二个，我们也可以用它300多个穴位，但是我们它是治疗头痛，我们可能是用来治疗咽喉肿痛，所以它主治的病症是不同的。
But the indications is a little bit different. But some points, in traditional Chinese medicine, is for headache. But we use it for another functions. 比如说，
你说
治头痛的，
对它用来治头痛的穴位，我们可以用它来治疗咽喉痛啊，就是它功用不一样啊。
The points, according to the traditional Chinese medicines, has the functions of.Of curing the headache, but we use these kinds of acupoints to treat the throat pain.
然后第三个就是它中医药性点灸本身它有它自己特定的穴位。
Zhuang medicine has our unique acupoints.
他自己的，因为我们刚说了，他是一个用穴归力啊，所以他自己的归力穴位不多啊，只是一归力，就是按我们刚说的那个归力来行，寒暑热背总站没这个归力来用。
嗯哼。However, we have fewer egg points. We have fewer unique points just from the joint medicine. Normally, we combine with the traditional medicine.
哦，好像这里面介绍穴位的，
后面有穴位，
是不是？那我们讲一讲它的操作方法啊。我觉得最重要的就是要操作方法要操作好。
Now we're talking about some medication.
一个是火炎，要准备好火炎，是用明火。
Okay, we have to prepare. First of all, we have to prepare the fire.
一般我们是用酒精灯是最好的。
Alcohol burner, we use it normally.
嗯，也就是药线，我们把药线要拿出来啊，备好药线。
Now we're talking about the preparations of the threat. How to get it out.
因为药线是用95的酒精浸泡的，所以跟火焰一定有一定的距离，要不然自己就把自己给烧了。
So we have to keep the threat away from the fire, because the threat actually is so wide that 95% equivalent.
第三就是体位啊，我们可以选坐位，也可以选卧位。
Okay, the position, the posture.We can choose to ask the patient in sit or lying down on the back.
第四个就要进行解释啊，要消除他们的顾虑。
The doctors must be very patient, and before the treatment, you have to explain to the patients how it works and what is going to happen.
就像刚刚大家担心的问题一样，是吧？因为你点着火以后，人家就觉得你这个火是不是会灼伤皮肤啊？
Because the most of the patients they think that maybe the fire burns our skin. You have to explain before that.
所以我们一定要解释清楚啊。这个是不会伤害皮肤啊，也不会灼伤皮肤啊。
So before treatment, you have to explain especially for the women, for the beautiful faces. You have to explain that it will not burn your face.
第五个一定要认真啊，要合理处方。
So seriously, we have to reasonable treatment.
因为这个是火啊，所以我们点灸的时候就比较嘻嘻哈哈的啊，这个要认真的。
Because during the treatment we are playing with fire, so during the treatment don't play any game.
Okay, responsible.
哎，这有我们可能就要示范了啊，给大家看一下。
Okay, later we will demonstrate how to prepare.
And prepare the threat. 这个是，嗯，我们把等一下解放，我跟大家示范一下，让大家这个手法很重要，要来学习一下。
Can try it on me if you want.
Do you want
to
pause it? Right.
Pause.
Yeah. Pause. Pause. Break. Do you want to break?
Sure.
5 minutes. 我一般一砸就是10灯。
It is our threat. As a threat from the junk medicines. This is one step with ten pieces.
这个药线里头有麝香的。
Well, we in some medicine, we do have the very special, special medicines from the animals, like 麝香, you know, 麝香.
Yeah, musk.
In each musk.
Cyclopics, no more. Musk.
The musk.
Musk. 所以一般妊妇我们是不太用这个方法
So therefore, normally we don't use it for the pregnant, women, because we have the 麝香 inside.
我们刚起初药线啊，第一步就是整线的、啊。我们哪说药线是卷卷卷的啊
？Okay, the first step for the administration is to ultimately the first.
我们把它扯直了。
Sorry out.
Extended. 因为我们这个手法很重要，大家看，一定要掌握这手法，要跟点灸手法不对，它就会起泡啊，就会有没有印记，可能就是跟我们的手法有很大关系。
Okay, it depends on your skill and depends on your old preparations.
你看我拉直了，这个是就是变成这样。
是要转吗？
不用转，就是一扯就扯了，
Extend.
你要就是磁线啊，大家看，是拇指和食指相对应啊，这个磁线，用出两个公分左右啊。
We use the two fingers to hold this thread, the index the fingers and thumb.
拇指和食指是线，小手指是拿来固定线的，中间有两个手指是可以拿来拉动这个线，因为这个小手指是固定的，这地方有一点松动啊，所以这两个手指是把那线收回来啊，是这样点的一个过程啊。
So like I hold the fist, the small like the last fingers to fix the thread.And the middle, the ring's finger and the middle fingers, we use the two fingers to control how long we should use.
我们一般是露出两个毫米，两个厘米啊。
Normally we use two centimeters.
因为本来我们要点火啊，如果是太近了，就会容易把自己的手给灼伤了啊。
If it's too short, it will burn ourselves.
留得太长了，你两个手指也收不回来啊。
If it's long, the the middle two fingers works.
这两个手指就像弹琴一样，把那个线收回来啊。收到还有0.5寸。
It's like playing just like playing violin. Just on the thread.
然后我们看就是点火啊。这个是线的姿势啊，你看这个手，这两个手指是悬空的，就是拉出这条线，这个地方是固定的。食指和
a little bit of two fingers very loose, not just too firm.
食指和拇指是稍微不是很紧的，有点松动啊。
It also is no very fixed, never fixed. We can.We can make it a little bit loose.
你看啊，就是这个时辰。可能连不上。这个我没发现。
这个我看。
没发现。没发现。没有，前面发的没有。
原来好像
原来有吧，
原来有。
等一下，我们放过来。
放
大点，
放大点。这个是有个那个视频的。
啊，对，有点。告诉他们那个连
不上，因为那个。Because of the computer's problems, we cannot just play the video.
How about you?
Or the PPT.
I've got a like one. Try.
Cheers.
Okay.
The lady.
Okay. 这就是第三个，就是点头啊，四个步骤里头。第三点。
The first step is to catch a fire.
我们前面讲了两个动作，就是为点头做准备啊。
The first two steps is just for the preparations.
我们点火啊，大概是两个公分左右啊，要点着。
Two centimeter.
点着火，我们把线收回来。当然不能像我现在示范那么慢，我们点的很快，我们就可以直接往。
这个是。We will do it very very quick.The demonstration, I just let you know how to catch a fire. That, but normally in clinic, we have to do it very fast.
点火就像我刚，大家注意看，就像我刚点那就可以了，不用点的很大，就这样就可以了。这是烛火。
So called the ball spark.
啊，不要点成明火，这是错误的。
Ball spark, the ball flame. The open flame means the wild or very very big flame is not acceptable.
第四个就是直接施灸啊，就点完火了就直接的往穴位或者肌肤上点了啊。
One tapping is one tapping.
对，一按就是一撞。一般点两到三撞。
One tapping, but I said one pressing. When the press is on the body, we call it one jump.
什么能
？Two jump, three jump, four jump.
它不会有什么啊？
能
不
能
练习？对施灸的方法。
Every point is one, two, three, three jumps.
这个就是他来点这个姿势
了。
因为这个世界首发的视频我们原来有的，这里没连上，所以等会我们有一个片子过后大家可以看一下。
After the PPT, we will print the videos just for you.
主要就是这个拇指关节动啊，还有带上这个腕关节啊。不是这样用力的点得起啊，不是这样用力。
The two important joint movement is from your thumb.
主要就是拇指关节啊。
Yeah, joint from thumb. According to the reaction.
再弹还在拇指啊，就是这么一按一下啊，点一下。很轻的啊。
We have to make this tapping slightly.
这个是错误的方法啊，不能自己的像针灸一样针下去。
We are showing the wrong posture, wrong manipulation.We cannot use this thread like a needle, just insert it directly on the body. It's totally different from the
acupuncture.
The insertions like acupuncture is not acceptable.
这什么时候可以用直接扎进去的方法呢？
But is there any times that we can use these kinds of insertions, just like a needle?
一个是点耳穴的时候可以。
We can use the director's insertions, like a needle, maybe use on the ear.
另外，点舌头和口腔溃疡的时候可以的。
We can use it in the mouth. of the author at mouth.
另外一些传染性的疾病，像疱疹啊这些，我们就不能用自己的手贴进去了。
Okay, and for some kinds of danger diseases, and which like the severe skin problems, maybe you can spare to the doctors. So we are not allowed to touch the patient directly.Therefore, we can use this kind of this manipulation.
我们中医这个叫非常规手法，这个就是刺的这种叫非常规手法。
Okay, so the director's instructions, just like a needle, we call it the irregular manipulations of Zhuang medicine.
也要用，但是不是常用的，所以是非常规的。
So we like to say this is abnormal, it's not for the daily using. The wrong action.
那么我们要注意的几个问题啊，这个是我们关系到我们点灸的作用和
There are some questions there. It related to the effects from our treatment.
第一个点灸有四种火候啊，在这四种火候中有三种是不能用，只有一种是能用的，我们介绍。
Okay, for the feng, we can see we have four kinds of feng: open line, clear flame, and general flame.There's only one flame you could use, like a ball flame.
点灸一定要掌握火候啊，最重要的不要烧伤皮肤。
Mm-hmm. The most important things you have to pay more attention to is that you have to take good care of your skin. Don't make it any burns.
我们讲一下啊，这就叫明火啊。
There's the wire, as in the big flame.
这个叫调火嘛，一调的叫调火。
And then it becomes the channel, the path.
这是明火吧？这两种火候是不能用的吗？
The open fire, and the channel fire we cannot use. And then the channel is live fire, or live flame. We cannot use.
这种火候能用的是珠火，圆珠状的。现在是禁火了，不能用了。
是 the fear or the ball flame you can use.
一点出来的圆珠状，现在是禁火了，也不能用了。就这个。
禁火是怎么样
子？很小了，不够力了。
The channel, actually. Just in Chinese, we translate this into the channel flame. Actually, it's weak flame.
所以我们一般动作要快，就是点着火啊，就点了以后啊，最佳的火候点着以后，这个是最佳火候，要直接揪上去。再等一会儿，它就拿很小的火候就能用。
So the time, we have to.We will pay more attention to the time when we should tap on the skins. So when it turns to the peel or the ball flame, which make the treatment. The others flame we are now allowed to use.
我们不能像拔火罐，我们这个就像拔火罐一样，不能从这点拿着一个火罐拿到那边去拔，一样的道理。
So timing is very important. It's just like cupping. If your timing is not right or not correct, you will fail it.
我们一般是火离灸的地方很近啊，或者比如说这火的这里，病人就要坐在这里。
If you do the treatment, the fly will be not far.Away from the threat and from the patient.
一般点着火以后，
从这里变到就到这里灸啊，变到红。
You can see the doctor stand here.
就这个过程啊。
Here, the patient is right. Yeah. Yeah, the bullfly is the best.
我们说还有三种手法，要大家就一个是四种火候，三种手法。
四种火候，
就刚说的。
So, for this kind of medicines, we have totally four flames and three.
四种手，三种手法。
三种手法 ，three manipulations.
三种手法。是一个是以轻应轻，以重应重，中为常用，中间的中。
中为常用
啊，就是最常用的这个方法。
Okay, actually it's very, very, very simple. It's just light, mild, and heavy. Light to light, heavy to heavy, mild to mild, middle to middle.
点灸手法是决定疗效一个重要因素，所以大家要掌握这个手法。
So manipulation is the key factors for the success of the treatment.
那么轻中重三种手法是怎么样去区别呢？
How can we tell?How can we tell the other people that we are using light, mild, or heavy manipulation?
我们庄医说的轻中重，并不是使用力的轻中啊重，而是点灸接触穴位或者接触皮肤的时间长短来区分的。
时间长短
啊，就是接触时间了。
There are totally three levels, since the light, middle, and heavy. Actually, we don't consider the three level according to the force for your finger. It is according to how long it will be manipulated on the point. It's the time.
灸，也就是点灸这个火。这个星星火星接触这个穴位时间长，就是重手法。
The longer, the heavier.
接触时间短，这个就是轻手法。
The shorter time, the lighter.
那重手法就是我们最常用的这两者之间啊。
Okay, the middle is between the two levels.No very light and no very heavy.
还有一种情况可以减轻这个刺激量的和增加刺激量的两种方法，可以告诉大家。
We do have two ways to make the stimulations heavier or lighter.
比如说我们点灸这个颜面部的和点灸小孩的时候，我们就用轻手法和刺激量小的。那怎么办呢？
The case for the kids or for the fissure points, we have to use the light stimulation.
小孩我们用轻，也是用小的。那我们把这个线啊，大家拿它这个线很粗，那我们可以顺着它的线去戳紧了啊。搓紧啊，搓紧啊，哎，这个刺激量就会小一些，就搓小一点了。
是，搓紧，
搓紧啊，
搓紧就会小一点。
啊，对。
If you want to make the stimulations lighter, then just make it tight.
Twisted.
Twisted.
那怎么样？得到重手法呢，就像我们刚说点灸那个理论型啊，像我们刚说的便秘理论型穴，还有他们用的多台也是用，怎么可以把药线可以搓成两，重复搓的一股。
Okay. How to make it heavier? We made two threads together.
还可以甚至还可以抽成四股吧。
And even they only did the two, even four pieces with it together.
一般是对那些
脚底
啊，皮肤比较厚的地方。
And we use it normally only for the buttons of the foot, or some area with many muscles.
第三个就是要注意避免感染。一般来说，要先点灸以后，不会像大家想象的会有什么很重的疤痕，不会。一般有一定就是被灼伤的一种小痕迹啊，一般一个星期到十天左右，它就会消失。
Okay, after the treatment or during the treatment, we can see the little or superficial scars, but after 1 week, it will disappear. It will not exist anymore.
Chen, what is the
picture? Good idea. This is good. This is
Yeah,
there's some phrase. It's forbidden. It's forbidden. The pregnant women is not allowed to accept this kind of therapy. It's now only because the animal medicine, like Shoshan, also because the strong stimulations on the voice.
S-H-E.
Mox.
Xiang is X-I-A-N-J. Xiang. I would assume it's synthetic, Shoshan, though. But synthetic, man-made, not real.
就是现在可能是想有人造了
的。有。有人工麝香，很多人都在使用人工麝香。在北京和整个。
It is from Beijing, and it's already has such kinds of man-made products.
我用的这个是从越南走私过来的。
So it actually got麝香 illegal from Vietnam.
Yeah, okay.
是仿冒嘛？
And they bought the Shoshans in Vietnam and some friends.
效果会好一些啊。
For present, and the effects will be better than the memory.
第三个，第二个眼球是不给灸。
And the eyeball also will be avoid of.
Is that included around the eye?
周边可以吧。眼球以外。
Okay, around the eyeball we can use, but directly on the eyeball that's not acceptable.
我们还用来治疗黑眼圈。
So if you work too long time, actually it's better for the women to be, you can see it's very black clouds on around the eyes. Actually we can use this therapy to relieve
the黑眼圈啊。
And for Chinese people, the problem is very severe.
第三个是男性的外生殖器，这龟头这部分和女性的这个小阴唇内就不能灸了。
Okay, number three is that.
Don't put it on your bits.
Understandable?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Genitals is an appropriate word.
That covers both without being so anatomical. 另外，那个点灸眼睛，就刚那个说的，点灸眼睛边上的穴位，要叫病人把眼睛眯上。
If you want to meditate on around the eyes, you have to ask the patient to close your eyes, to close the patient's eyes.If the patients feel too nervous or too hungry, let's not allow to to accept the reparation. It do like the traditional Chinese medicine, acupuncture. When we do the acupuncture, we ask the patient to eat something before the treatment. Otherwise they will become too hungry or the energy will be too low.
因为点灸这个面部的穴位一律用清除法。Okay,
the preparations on the facial area must be very very light.
这是我们注意的一些事情啊，因为我们都注意到了啊，那我觉得我们基本上就没有什么问题的啊，我示范一下了啊。
Okay, we're gonna demonstrate you the hands.